Good afternoon, students. Today we will start our seventh topic, Indian Ocean Relief and Strategic Importance. The Indian Oceans is the third largest ocean in the world after Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. It is the only ocean in the world named after a particular country, India. About 20% of the total ocean area occupied by the Indian Ocean. Part of the Indian Ocean is located in the southern hemisphere. Indian Ocean spread between Africa in the West, Asia in the north and the east, Australia in the east, and southern ocean in the south. Note that unlike Pacific and Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean does not extend northward to the Arctic Ocean. This situation has resulted in complete blockage of the Indian Ocean towards its north east. Peculiar arrangement of the ocean and the continental portion contribute a lot to the development of monsoon climates of the Indian subcontinent. Next topic is important relief of Indian Ocean. The floor of Indian Ocean exhibits complex and varied features like a continental shelf, milled oceanic ridges, ocean basin, oceanic deeps, islands, etc. These features are formed by tectonic, volcanic, and denotation process. This process operated in the same manner as like that the continents, the average depth of the Indian Ocean is 4,000 meters. It also has a few marginal seas. Next is a continental shelf. It is a portion of continents submerged under ocean water. It is normally occupied by different gulfs, seas, bays, and straits. There is a wide range of variation in the continental shelves of Indian Ocean. Quite extensive shelves are found along the Indian coast. The eastern coast of Africa and Madagascar record relatively narrow, while the of continental shelf and along the Indonesian coast. It is a very narrow, 660 kilometers. The continental shelves are very wide in the west side of Indian wares. There are narrow along the eastern coast. Continental shelves are the vineyard with deposits brought down the terrestrial agents of erosion. Some of the sedimentary deposits received over 1,000 years as they remain deposits for a long time. Sedimentary rocks are formed. Some of them are potential source of fuel food. Melt oceanic ridges. Melt ocean ridges are submerged mountain range that the separate deep portion of the sea. Ocean floor. In India Ocean also has a mid-oceanic range called a mid-Indian Oceanic Ridges. It origins Gulf Aden near the peninsula of Somali. Further is extending towards the sound and at east side of Madagascar. It divide into two branches. Among these, one branch divides towards southwest and extend up the Prince Edward's Islands. It is known as the Southwest Indian Ocean Ridges. Second branch extend southeast up the Amsterdam and St. Paul Islands. Mid Indian Ocean ridges has many parallel ridges. This ridges is not a continuous due many fracture zone in it, such as a Owen fracture zone, Amsterdam fracture zone, etc. Apart from it, in South Indian Ocean there is a Kerguelen plateau in south side of Madagascar. In Madagascar plateau and in south side of Africa in Algoals plateau. In the west of Indian, in the Indian Ocean, the Chagos plateau, which extend up a mid Indian Ocean range ridges, there are many archipelagos and islands in these parts of Indian Ocean, such as Lakshadweep, Maldives, Diego, Ganzima, etc. In the eastern India Ocean, Bay of Bengal, there is along the north-south extending ridges called as 19th East Ridges. Its origins from the west of Andaman and Nicobar Islands and extend southward up the eastern part of the Amsterdam St. Paul Islands. Next is the islands of Indian Ocean. In this section, we shall consider mostly the deep sea islands and not the coastal islands. Beside the large islands like Australia, Madagascar and Sri Lanka, there are large number of islands and located in the Indian Ocean. These can be grouped as islands of Arabian Sea, along Bay of Bengal, Australian coast and islands near Antarctica. Islands in the Arabian Sea. In Arabian Sea, one can identify two subgroups such as those close to Africa coast and the ones along central ridges, Lakshadweep, Chagos ranges. Almost these closer the African coast, Madagascar is the largest island. It has an area of 5.9 lakhs square kilometer. It's believed by most of the geologists that Madagascar was a part of African continent in geological part. It has undergoes two separations, such as the first separation from Africa and later from the Indo-Australian plateau. It is one of the seismologically active provinces. There are number of islands between Madagascar and eastern coast of Africa. Notably, amongst them are Comoro, Bessas, the India, Europe islands. To the east, Madagascar, the islands like Reunion, Mauritius, Seychelles. In the north, close to African Horn leaves, islands of Socotra. All those islands are to the west of mid Indian Ocean ridges. These forming a group of islands along Lakshadweep, Chagos ridges are Lakshadweep, Maldives, Chagos. Most of these are in the form of archipelagos formed by coral atolls. Beside these islands, there are a few islands like a Bundel islands near the coast of Pakistan and few islands such as the Kashi, Hendroravi, Lavan, Siri, etc. are found along the Persian Gulf part of Iran. Second is islands of Bay of Bengal. The largest amongst these groups is the Sri Lanka islands. Its islands to east of 19 degree east ridges are the groups of islands like Andaman and Nicobar. A chain of islands along the western coast of Sumatra Islands of Indonesia. Barring a few coral islands in Nicobar group, most of these islands are volcanic islands. All the islands are associated with the converging plateau boundary. The islands are the peaks of submerged mountain. Third is the islands along Australian coast. There are very few islands along the western coast of Australia. Nowadays, amongst these are Ashmore, Kismas, Posses, or Killing Islands. Next topic is the ocean basin. The term ocean basin indicates deep flat area of the ocean water. On a global scale, all major oceans are called ocean basins. Each of the oceans has number of small ocean basins within it. These ocean basins are terminal destinational for the sediments brought from the continents as well as their generated within the oceanic part. The Indian Ocean has 10 major ocean basins. Next part is the deeps and dredges. Dredges are the deepest portion in the ocean. There are very few deeps and dredges in the Indian Ocean as compared to other oceans. Most of the dredges of Indian Ocean are located toward the eastern boundary. These are located along the converging boundaries between the Indo-Australian Plateau and the Pacific Plateau. Most nowadays amongst these are Java, Sunda trenches, 7,450 meter deep, and O trench, 6,875 meters deep. This area simultaneously active because of plate movements. Next topic is distribution of temperature and salinity in the Indian Ocean. The study of temperature of ocean is essential of influence the biotic components in the ocean. It is also largely responsible for the movements in the oceanic water. Other factors besides the temperature, it is a salinity. The density of ocean water depend upon the temperature and salinity of ocean water. The density of temperature difference causes the movements in seawater. Let us take up the study of temperature distribution in Indian Ocean. During the pre-monsoon season, when the summer solstice is approaching, the temperature generally increase high and much higher in the southern portion closer the equator. Once the southwest monsoon sets in, the temperature pattern get altered with lowering of temperature in the Arabian Sea around, which comes under the influence of monsoonal winds. By the seasonal of northeast monsoon, when the winter solstice approaches, the temperature get reduced. The northern part of Bay of Bengal record temperature of the order of 24 degrees Celsius. Next topic is the Indian Ocean salinity. The other characteristics of ocean water is salinity. Salinity is a measure of amount of salts in the seawater. It is exposed as part per thousand percentage. Average salinity of seawater is 35 degrees. You will notice that the map showing the distribution of salinity have a particular pattern. The salinity is generally high around the Somali Peninsula and closer to the Saudi Arabian coast. These are the regions having high temperature and low rainfall. Not many rivers enter in the sea in this area. In case of Bay of Bengal, huge discharge from Ganga system and also from the peninsular rivers lead to the lowering of salinity in this area. Comparing the three maps, you will notice that the salinity is less during the period of southwest monsoon. Next topic is ocean currents in Indian Ocean. The pattern of currents in Indian Ocean differs considerably from these in Pacific or Atlantic Ocean. The effects of monsoon wind system is clearly seen on the currents in northern Indian Ocean. Ocean currents are bodies of ocean waters maintaining their separate entity. They flow across oceans under the influence of specific wind systems. They perform the functions of mixing of water and transport of heat from one part of ocean to the other. Ocean currents are classified as warm or cold currents depending on the temperature conditions of the flowing water in them. System of ocean currents in the Indian Oceans is highly influenced by shape of its coast line, its extent, and the particular arrangement of the wind system that prevails in the regions. It has equatorial currents, but the north equatorial currents is weaker than the south equatorial currents. North or equatorial, its currents are influenced by the seasonal reversing monsoon wind system. The currents systems in the southern part of Indian Ocean leads to development of the large gyre. The two major arms of this gyre are south equatorial current flowing east to west direction under the influence of Easterline. The west wind drift following from west to east under the influence of Westline. The circulation is completed in the west by Mozambique Agulhas currents and in the east by West Australian currents. It is considered to be one of the major gyre of global scale. In the northern portion of the Indian Ocean, seasonal monsoonal wind drive in currents. Mostly these currents flow along the coastlines. During summer, they flow clockwise direction, and during the winter, their direction shows complete reversal there and they flow in anti-clockwise direction. Next topic is the importance of Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean region contains namely Asian, Africa, and Australia. It supports some of Asia's biggest economies. This along shows the economic and political significance that it has. It contains three business straits, namely Hormuz, Malacca, and Bab al Mandeb. Majority of crude oil export by Gulf countries pass through these routes via Strait of Hormuz. Hence, the Indian Ocean serves an important route of crude oil supports worldwide several islands countries such as the Maldives, Seychelles are located in the Indian Ocean. The economy of these countries entirely developed upon the marine ecosystem and marine tourism in the Indian Ocean. Student, let us see. In next video, we will see what is the strategical importance of Indian Ocean.
The Indian Ocean region is one of the most densely populated region in the world. It contains one-third of the world's population. Its ocean, the Indian Ocean, is the third largest among world's oceanic division. This region is blessed with vast resource of natural resources. Since few decades, the Indian Ocean region has witnessed a dramatic shift at economic and strategic level, leading to a rise in new major powers possessing immense potential to influence world affairs with their rising economy. In this report, we will learn about factors that make this region significant. We will also focus on its geography, natural resources, trade, and its strategic importance in the world. Support us through Patreon. Your support helps us to grow.
Next topic is the importance of Indian Ocean for India. India occupies a central of strategic location of Indian Ocean area. It is national and economical interests is the instantly linked up with Indian Ocean. Hence, to keep the Indian Ocean as a zone of peace from free from the superpower rivalry and increasing cooperation along the littoral countries in the region has always been Indian foreign policy goal. For example, Indian Ocean Rim Association for Regional Cooperation, BIMSTEC and Ganga Mekong Cooperation, etc. No industrial development, commercial growth, stable political structure is possible unless countries' shore are protected. Most of the conflicts since the end of the Cold War has also taken place in or around the Indian Ocean region. As a result, almost all the world's major powers have developed sustainable military force in the Indian Ocean region. A major concern of India in the Indian Ocean is energy. India is fourth largest economy in the world. It is almost 70% depends on oil import, major part of which comes from Gulf region. The Indian Ocean provides major sea route connecting the Middle East, Africa, and East Asia with Europe and the Americas. It carries particularly heavy traffic of petroleum and petroleum products from the oil field of the Persian Gulf and Indonesia. Large rivers of hydrocarbons are being trapped in the offshore area of Saudi Arabia, Iran, India was Western Australia. In estimated 40% of the world's offshore oil products come from the Indian Ocean. Beach sands rich in heavy minerals and offshore deposits are actively exploited by bordering countries, particularly India, South Africa, Indonesia, and Sri Lanka. With the increasing trade relation with the countries of the East, India has higher stocks in the regions in the year to come. Trade value with the Asian countries have more than doubled in a decrease from more $1,484 million in 1993. The Indian market has emerged as one of the largest imports of the Southeast Asian gold, with the import touching $10,942 million in 2004. The recently concluded free trade arrangements with countries like Thailand and Singapore, as said, the contribute to the trade. Expecting market and larger import flows imply not only economic prosperity but also vulnerability at sea. The incidence of primary arms robbery and maritime tourism are on the rise and has placed a premium on the complexity of sea lane defense. The northern area of the Indian Ocean is the area of great significance in economic and strategic trades. Indian Forensic Policy Organization toward the eastern neighbors has spurred interest and attention here. Indian burgeoning economy and forecast to become one of the three fastest growing economies in the world. Index explains of existing export and import market. Being seafaring nation with islands neighbors has added to the need for safe sea lane in the interlying water. The world's busiest choke point in the Strait of Malacca, located here, added complexity to a strange fact. Thank you, students.